If the playoffs are all about opportunity, the Carolina Hurricanes arrived tonight with a tremendous opportunity. Their heroics in game number 3 of this series have put them in a great spot to get a stranglehold on this best of 7. But for the opponents, they realize they're dealing with adversity, and tonight, they have to be at their best. Game 4, straight ahead on Fox Sports Carolinas.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the home of the brave.
As only she can do it, KK Fritch with a star-spangled banner as we get set for game number 4. And as we said at the outset, opportunity knocks for Carolina and a chance to get a stranglehold on this best of 7 series. We'll take a look at the goaltenders. Tim Thomas was very good for Boston, although he did, as Tripp pointed out in the open, gave up a few rebounds, but expect an A-caliber game from the Vezina Trophy finalist here tonight. Cam Ward, what else can we say? Saving the bacon once again in overtime, keeping Carolina in a tied position so the game could be won by UC Jokinen. The referees tonight are Kevin Pollock and Dave Jackson, Sean Moran, Thor Nelson on the lines. For Carolina, Ryan Beta out with the flu. Tim along the kick plate all the way back to Whitney. Whitney holding onto it. Centering this way. Yone picking it up top. It's Corvo. Joe Corvo advancing. Knocked down by Axelson. Shorthanded breakaway. All alone on Cam Ward. He says no! What a save by Cam Ward. Yone picking it. Will snap it from the blue line. Hard around it goes. Blake Wheeler. Broken up, centered out in front, Pickenin's there, a chance, they score! Eric Staal brings down the house, Carolina with a 1-0 lead.
John, I'll say it one more time. Best players have to be your best players and the two cornerstones of the franchise. Cam Ward had from the offensive or the blue line in to think about how he was going to play Axelson, not a noted goal scorer, and the other cornerstone is able to beat the guy with a shot through him at the other end. So you see the goaltending matchup between the Vezina finalist and the guy who's the best goalie in hockey right now.
Savard, Recchi on the doorstep. Savard scores! Mark Savard from a tough angle as he ignites the Boston attack. They've tied it.
Well, it begins with the power move to the front by Recchi. And Savard, who is looking to reinstate his leadership after the penalty in game 3. That's a huge save on the deflection. Now Recchi's going to come with a power move. And the quick shot, boy, just like Staal in the first period, did Savard ever snap this thing quickly? And Cam got it with his glove, but didn't get enough.
The juice and back of the goal, holding onto it up top now. Cruising is Seidenberg. One-timer, Babchuk, fouled off by Thomas. Loose, they score! Turn on the juice!
Chuck made a huge defensive play. He's been fighting confidence. John, I think it had a direct reflection on him getting that one-timer to the net that starts the whole flurry that leads to the goal. What a play, taking away the passing lane on Savard. Then he gets out to the point. He's ready to fire a puck. That was more conviction than Babchuk has shown in some time. You've got traffic in front. Staal denied on the initial rebound. And it's UC Jokinen once again. Boy, oh boy, Stewart. Can't find him.
Jokinen, over the line, in the zone. Here's Samsonov cutting, walking out in front.
Yeah! hands on deck. Watch the left side of your screen. Take the hit to make the play by Ruutu. Off comes Jokinen and then Samsonov, the same three guys that teamed up on the overtime winner. And when Sergei Samsonov's on, everybody refers to Sergei as dancing. Well, he's dancing right here. What a move, what a finish to the backhand. So you have Ruutu taking the hit, Jokinen carrying it up the ice, and then the one-on-one quickness and finish by Sergei Samsonov.
They come, you see Jokinen moving up on Savard, shaking off Savard. All the way back up top now for Korvo, and a penalty is called against Boston. They've come off their discipline again. Stahl walks in, shoots, scores!
I just got electrocuted. Wow. Savard had taken the original penalty for slashing. And Stahl was just off the bench. You know what, John? We're going to take another look. I think Stahl was off for Cam Ward. You see the referee. So the extra man, the delayed sequence, he comes in with a ton of speed. And he beats Thomas with a beautifully placed snapshot to the blocker side.
Just listen. And a disturbance, Rod Brind'Amour, Chuck Kobusu.
Great job by the linesman to get in there, stop this thing before it started.
Will hang his head. Off the faceoff, that'll do it. Carolina gets it done.
Play gets it done in these two games, doesn't it? Stahl just continues to beat to that same drum. Carolina continues to be undefeated when he scores. That chance goes up when he's got not one but two goals. Cam Ward, he just showed it. Big saves at the big times. I think the penalty killing, another story, even giving up a power play goal to Savard. But to me, the biggest thing is it just continues to be a little thing called all hands on deck.
It boils down to who's the better team, and right now the team in red has everything pointing in that direction. They defeat the Boston Bruins by a margin of 4-1. Yes, it's a Carolina iced tea party here in Raleigh. The Canes lead the best of seven series, 3-1, and we're going to keep it here for the three-star selection.
I might go to that iced tea party based on who's holding that banner. What a game. Tough to pick three stars when you have, like I said, all the contributions.
We won't pick them. They are selected for us. Tuomo Ruutu, the number three star. Eric Stahl got the ball rolling tonight. 7-0 when he scores in the playoffs. And 3 points for the Juice. Center. Carolina victorious. Yes, we can. And the Canes are that much closer. 1 game away from the Eastern Conference Finals. Stay with us. It's the RBC Bank Hurricanes Live coming your way next. Game 6, if needed, is here. Game 5, Sunday in Boston.